Have you ever encountered this? When you mention an electric car, people automatically think of Tesla. You assume Tesla means the best. And indeed, for many years, it seemed like only Elon Musk and his company were involved in the development of electric vehicles. But is that really the case? Were Tesla electric cars the first? Are they still the best? What does the future hold for the industry, if anything at all? We will answer these and many other questions in today's video. But before we debunk or confirm the myth of Tesla's hegemony, let's clarify that for this video we have tried not to include hybrid electric cars, those with a combination of battery and internal combustion engine. Today we are only talking about pure electric cars. Let's get started. How long do you think humanity has been engaged in production of electric motors? Those who answer from the 2000s are likely to be keeping a close eye on Elon Musk's activities. Those who answer from the 1990s are more immersed in the subject. But what if I told you that the common belief that electric cars are a new trend, simply a fad for all things eco-friendly, is not entirely correct? That the first electric motors appeared 35 years before the familiar internal combustion engines. That electric motors lost the popularity race as early as the beginning of the 20th century. Well, that's exactly how it happened. Just imagine. In 1910, electric cars accounted for 38% of the entire automobile market in the United States. And in 2021, it's only 12.8%. And this is considered a success with record sales growth over the past 3 years. But let's go back to 1910. 4 out of 10 cars in the United States were running on electricity. What could possibly go wrong? Well, then came World War I, and there was a significant need for fast, long-distance transportation, especially for heavy loads. And here is the thing. An electric motor was sufficient for city driving, but not for intercity or international travel. In the early 20th century, there wasn't cheap enough technology to create high-capacity batteries. It turned out to be easier to work on the drawbacks of internal combustion engine cars. Engineers improved reliability, worked on clutch and transmission systems, and obtained vehicles capable of transporting heavy loads on inexpensive fuel. That was it. By the 1930s, electric cars not only ceased production, but any further discussion of their development and existence stopped. And as you can imagine, discussions about the concept of electric transportation only resurfaced when there was a breakthrough in energy storage technology. And that breakthrough did happen. Let me give you an example that is practically ubiquitous in our time – the mobile phone. In 1983, Motorola introduced the first cellular phone for public sale. It was a miracle of miracles. The device weighed about 1 kilogram thanks to its battery, and it could last for only about half an hour of conversation. Just compare that to modern smartphones that weigh less than 300 grams. The same goes for batteries for electric cars. They have become smaller, cheaper, and last longer. That's why we're witnessing a global race among automotive manufacturers to create the best electric vehicle. And let's be honest, the automotive industry is interested in making them more durable and affordable. That will be the main direction of technological development in the industry for the next 10 years. And who's participating in the race, you might ask? We definitely won't limit ourselves to just Tesla. Of course, Tesla is a pioneer in the industry. While other automotive giants dismissed the idea of electric transport as a passing fad, quickly losing relevance, Tesla unveiled its first electric car in 2006. Its sales impressed competitors so much that after 10 years, it seemed like everyone was announcing their own version of an eco-friendly vehicle. Some even promised to transition all their production to electric engines. But in another 10 years, Tesla might not be at the top anymore. And this is happening right before our eyes. Yes, the Model S can reach speeds ranging from 249 to 322 km an hour, depending on the configuration. The range without recharging also varies from 628 to 837 km. Yes, Tesla's electric cars are quiet, fast, and easy to handle, but is that enough in 2023, when competitors are right on their heels? Will PR stunts like launching a Tesla into space or doors that open upwards be enough to keep Elon Musk's company ahead? We'll find out soon. For example, the Chinese have also made a sedan called the Voyah Zhuiguang, which is 200 to 300 kilograms lighter than its competitors. It can travel up to 710 kilometers without recharging, and it charges quickly. A 10-minute charge can cover 230 kilometers, and even half an hour on an extra-fast charge is enough to not worry about the battery. In contrast, the Model S takes at least 2 hours. And remember, these are electric cars, so their speed decreases as the battery drains. By the way, there is a detailed video on the channel about the Chinese automotive industry. If you're interested, be sure to check it out. Next in line is the Nissan Leaf hatchback. For several years, it was the best-selling electric car of the year. Only in 2020 did it lose the title to Tesla's Model 3, which became the best-selling electric car in history. But let's see if the Leaf has any advantages over its well-known rival. Yes, the range of the Leaf on a full charge is quite modest – 341 km. The top speed is 140 km an hour, and it takes 7.9 seconds to accelerate from 0 to 100 km per hour, while the Tesla Model S takes half that time – 3.9 seconds. In terms of all parameters, the Leaf is more of a family car, not meant for high-speed pursuits, and since it's a family car, its price is more affordable. That's the first point. And secondly, let's look at the performance of an electric car over time. Tesla promised that their car batteries would last for 15 years. However, in reality, after just 5 years of driving, the battery's power output is 20% lower than when it was new. This naturally affects both speed and driving range. What about the Leaf? It experiences the same 20% loss in power after the first 5 years of use. But here is the catch. It can last for up to 22 years. Considering the average lifespan of a car is 10 to 12 years, that's pretty good, right? The engineers at Nissan were so inspired by these numbers that they are actively considering the secondary use of batteries. After all, you don't just get rewarded for having a beautiful body. You also need the most eco-friendly means of transportation, especially when you're competing against Elon Musk's company. Let's move from something family-oriented and simple to something more luxurious, namely the Jaguar I-Pace sports crossover. Yes, even Jaguar is involved in electric transportation. A full battery charge on the Jaguar I-Pace will last for almost 400 km, and a 30-minute recharge provides an additional 30 km. This electric crossover accelerates from 0 to 100 km per hour in 4.9 seconds, but the maximum speed is limited to 200 km per hour because the company decided it was safer and restricted the electronics. How about advantages over Tesla? No problem. For example, it charges to 80% battery capacity faster. It only takes Jaguar 85 minutes for that. And if you invest in a more powerful charging device, you can do it in just 45 minutes. All thanks to one of the most powerful batteries among electric car models. But let's be honest, Jaguar is loved not only for its speed. Many experts appreciate its expensive and stylish interior and well-designed body lines. Yes, Jaguar is preferred by luxury enthusiasts, and the company won't stop there. So far, we've mentioned quite well-known brands, right? Let's take a look at the dark horse of the market, the Lucid Air. If you can call an electric car developed by a former chief engineer of Tesla a dark horse. Can you feel the competition going all out? The maximum speed of 376 km per hour was limited at the software level. The electronics prevented from accelerating beyond 270 km per hour. In other words, potentially this electric car is faster than any Tesla. But the manufacturers care about your safety. Thanks to not only a powerful battery, but also the nearly perfect aerodynamic design of the body, you can go far with this car, up to 837 km to be exact. As noted by the chief engineer of Lucid Air, who once had a hand in Tesla's Model S, when he joined Elon Musk's company, the exterior design of the car was already almost finalized, and the challenge was to fit powerful components into a structure that couldn't be changed, leading to some engineering shortcomings. And these shortcomings were rectified by Rawlinson in the Lucid Air, as all the necessary parts for power are positioned as optimal as possible. What about speed? This electric car only needs 20 minutes of direct current charging and it can travel an additional 400 km. That's a remarkable advantage over Tesla. It's no wonder that in 2023, Lucid Air received the award for the best luxury car at the International Auto Show in New York. So there you have it, the dark horse. Next, let's discuss the car that Tony Stark drove. Elon Musk appeared in Iron Man, you might say, that's not an argument. It's a tie. But let's take a closer look at the Audi e-tron. You can charge up to 80% in just half an hour, as long as you have a more powerful charging device. It accelerates to 200 km per hour, and it reaches 100 km per hour in 6.6 seconds, which is slower than Tesla. However, like Tesla and Chevrolet Bolt, the Audi e-tron has a regenerative braking system, which allows for an extended maximum range on a full battery charge. I hope you don't get the impression that Tesla unquestionably wins here, because now it's time to talk about the unbeatable advantage of the Audi Q8 e-tron over the Tesla Model S. It turns out that this particular version of the Audi has performed well in cold weather. It loses just over 10% of its energy range, and it can travel 331 km at a temperature of minus 6.5 degrees Celsius, instead of the 370 km it can cover in spring-summer. In comparison, the Tesla Model S loses 30-40% of its range depending on the configuration. Not bad, right? So what does the future hold for electric cars? Skeptics evaluate the economy, government funding, and tax incentives for automakers, expressing a lack of optimism in sales growth, arguing that the market is not expanding fast enough, and asserting that humanity will never fully transition to electric transportation. They even present calculations by scientists that suggest if all the cars currently in use suddenly became electric, there wouldn't be enough electricity to go around. The system couldn't handle it. However, apart from the skeptics, nobody talks about an immediate and drastic shift. The electric transportation industry is slowly but steadily capturing its share of the market, quietly and reliably, just like the electric vehicles themselves. Engineers are focused on making battery production cheaper and electric cars more accessible to a wider range of people with different income levels. For now, battery production technology for electric cars is imperfect. There are even issues with environmentally friendly disposal of faulty batteries. For example, Nissan is actively exploring options for the secondary use of battery materials or entire batteries, aiming to unveil them at the launch of a new electric vehicle. Jaguar, on the other hand, plans to create a network of wireless charging taxi services. The carbon footprint of passenger cars is only part of the environmental burden. If we also switch to electric transportation for freight, then we'll be living the dream, according to Tesla. They started developing a prototype for an electric truck. Meanwhile, in Sweden, Scania has gone even further and already showcased the next electric vehicle prototype, which is unique for its interchangeable body. Essentially, it's a platform with an engine and wheels onto which the desired module can be attached. Need a garbage truck? No problem. Want to transport goods? Done! You can even turn it into a passenger bus by 2030. Currently, one of the drawbacks is the limited selection of electric cars. People say they all look the same, and companies have only recently begun unveiling SUV models. Variety along with affordability is perhaps the closest solution to this problem. But wait, in the BMW group, they've planned to release 12 electric car models by 2027. Toyota promises 10 models and aims to stop producing internal combustion engine vehicles altogether by 2027, all for the purpose of capturing the Chinese market. The Chinese government is actively fighting carbon emissions, implementing relevant quotas and laws. Volvo and Jaguar are also eyeing China, with plans to produce exclusively electric cars by 2030. It's worth noting that everyone has grand sales targets. Toyota plans to reach 1 million electric cars sold by 2030, while Volkswagen aims to achieve that number by 2025. BMW, on the other hand, plans to sell 2 million electric cars by 2025. And what about Tesla? Tesla already has a 55% share of the American market, but Elon Musk wouldn't be himself if he didn't set ambitious goals for his company. Specifically, by 2027, Tesla aims to reach a production volume of 20 million electric cars. This is in contrast to the 500,000 vehicles produced in 2020. Based on these calculations, two-thirds of the electric car market would belong to Tesla. Only time will tell. So what do you think? Has anyone managed to surpass Tesla, or is Elon Musk's company still the best in its segment? Share your thoughts in the comments. And now we're off to prepare new videos for you. See you soon!